the impact David had on my life. He was the brother from another mother who would come to my house on the weekends, and he would share my room. And I would be thrilled. My big brother's coming over. And he would come. I had these bunk beds. And he'd get in the top bunk, and I'd be on the bottom, and he'd smuggle in these little transistor radios. Some of you old people remember. And we would just sing all night long with AM radio. 93KHJ. He'd be singing all these tunes, laughing our butts off. He would be telling me stories of our dad. David was 8 and a half years older than me, so he had a lot more time with my dad. And we would laugh, and we would beat the hell out of each other in these pillow fights, and we would never sleep. So I cherished these weekends when he would show up, because I was the oldest in the house until he was around. David's the guy who taught me how to drive a car when I was 9. Sure, you can do it. David is the first person to talk to me about girls. And that's the end of that sentence. David ended up on the Partridge Family. Everything got surreal. I mean, my mom was famous. We had an Academy Award on the mantle in our living room, but David was just David. He was the guy from my room, the bunk in my room, and suddenly he's like the biggest star in the world. It scared me. It scared me for him. If we're lucky, our siblings are the only ones we get to take this whole ride with. It's not our parents. It's not our kids. It's our brothers and sisters. I cherish my two younger brothers, Patrick and Ryan, and there is not a day goes by where I don't think about David in this. Toward the end of his life, when he was facing so many health challenges, it became increasingly difficult to be around him. Too many pills and too much alcohol had taken him away from us. But fortunately, miraculously, near the end, he came back to his family. And we were laughing again and singing again. This is a song he used to do with the Partridge Family. Will there come a day when you and I can sing? We can finally see each other. Will there come a time we can find the time to reach out for one another? We've been traveling in circles such a long, long time, trying to say hello. And we could just let it ride, but you're someone that I'd like to get to know. I'll meet you halfway. That's better than no way. Must be some way to get it together. And if there's some way, I know that someday we just might work it out forever. David and I ever worked together as actors was in a Broadway show called Blood Brothers. The final song was a powerful anthem we sang with Petula Clark. And it was about life and loss and ultimately acceptance. Kathleen, if you'll cover for Petula, I'll do my best to cover for David. Tell me it's not true. Say it's just a story, something on the news. Tell me it's not true, though it's here.
Please see.